Right, we're at Union Building or Union Station in Los Angeles, about to leave for a 48-hour trip to Michigan for the Parricidal Effect. I've got my good buddy here who we found through Fate and Design. He's going to be joining me on this expedition to go to Michigan, suss out all the locations, get our LLC going, get qualified for Section 181, find our crew and our cast, and we're on the verge here because we've got 5, 6, 7 bags amongst us, and the trains only allow 2 bags each. And also the fact that the red one is coming with us, or at least the red scarlet. And I have an HPX documentary camera coming with us, and they specifically specified no fragile goods. So we're on the verge. Anyway, we're going in, and we'll see you on the train. Union Station, man. Cool, so we had a little bit of trouble checking in that one parcel. If you tilt down to the big red, big yellow case,
yeah,
and then back to me, it was too heavy, so I had to do a switch, and that the red is now currently on board the train in the luggage compartment, which I was hoping would be the other way around. And they kind of asked if it was fragile, and I had to say no. But so I'm taking all the accessories, which I was hoping was the other way around. Right. Anyway, we're on, and my friend Matrix here has kindly taken one of my bags. And how do you feel, man?
I feel good. I feel great. I'm ready.
Cool.
Let's go. All right.
Here we go. So yeah, we're on the train, and bit of a sweat in that. We found a good compartment, much better than the hostel we've been staying in. So so yeah, this is the beginning of our 48-hour trek. And weather permitting, apparently there's a snowstorm tearing through Texas, so hopefully it's not going to affect our trip. And yeah, from now on we're just going to keep you in the loop as far as, you know, different scenery is concerned. And hope we make it there in one piece, and more importantly, I hope my red makes it there in one piece. So it's the first morning of our trip to Chicago. We've probably still got another 36 hours ahead. And snowy outside, in fact, in that we can see remnants of obviously a snowstorm that they had. But other than that, it's an absolute pleasure. There's coffee on board, there's some food on board. The scenery's getting better. So yeah, we've got another 36 hours to look forward to. Oh, that's the end of the line. So we stopped off in the middle of the Wild West somewhere, and what I discovered while I was here on the train is that I left some of the battery chargers for the camera in the main cargo. So we quickly ran over to town and got a coffee, and then realized we had 10 minutes to find our cargo and find the battery. So I managed to find my shorts, getting changed because it's damn hot inside the cabin, even though there's snow outside. And I managed to find the red, so it's now with us, and the pressure's off in wondering whether or not the red is safe. So we have everything we need for the next 30 hours. So we're on the train to Chicago. What I do to keep myself busy is literally we've been taking a lot of footage of the journey and the different kind of location scenarios. And then I'm cutting together the diversity of the locations and putting it in a little cut, which I then post onto the Facebook page to inform the social network audience what we're up to. And the backup plan for the film is that if we can't get a distributor, then we self-distribute the film, and by that I need to have already started building an audience. So that's kind of what we do. We've got a little station set up here, we got a Starbucks coffee that we always rush off to the kiosk to get some hot water, and then we throw in our own herbal tea, so the journey becomes a little bit more affordable. And yeah, we've just been bouncing ideas through the whole journey, and we've surprisingly nearing the end now, and got most of our work done.
So for the last 24 hours, we seem to have been passing through a lot of snowed-down towns, or snowed-in towns at least. And this morning, we arrived at Kansas City, where it's pretty much still snowing, but it looks like the perfect location for the parasitical effect. Only thing is, I went online quickly and checked, it doesn't have a taxi setup, but this is the kind of terrain we're looking for.
Down to Georgia, he was looking for a soul to steal. He was in a bind because he was way behind and he was willing to make a deal. When he came across this young man sawing on a fiddle and playing it hot, and the devil jumped up on a hickory stump and said, "Boy, let me tell you what. I guess you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you'd care to take a dare, I'll make a bet with you. Now you play pretty good fiddle, boy, but give the devil his due. I bet a fiddle of gold against your soul because I think I'm better than you." The boy said, "My name's Johnny, and it might be a sin, but I'll take your bet and you're gonna regret, cause I'm the best as ever been.
Johnny, rosin up your bow and play your fiddle hard, cause hell's broke loose in Georgia and the devil deals the cards. And if you win, you get this shiny fiddle made of gold, but if you lose, the devil gets your soul."
Opened up his case and he said, "I'll start this show." And fire flew from his fingertips as he rosined up his bow. And he pulled the bow across the strings and it made an evil hiss. And then a band of demons joined in and it sounded something like this. Devil finished, Johnny said, "Well, you're pretty good, old son, but sit down in that chair right there and let me show you how it's done.
Fire on the mountain, run, boys, run. The devil's in the house of the rising sun. Chicken in the bread pan, picking out dough. Granny, does your dog bite? No, child, no."
The devil bowed his head because he knew that he'd been beat, and he laid that golden fiddle on the ground at Johnny's feet. Johnny said, "Devil, just come on back if you ever want to try again. I done told you once, you son of a bitch, I'm the best as ever been." He played,
"Fire on the mountain, run, boys, run. Devil's in the house of the rising sun. The chicken in the bread pan, I'm picking out dough. Granny, where you don't fight, no child, no."
So 48 hours, we're here in Chicago finally, and no major crisis other than a few drunkards that kind of gave us a bit of grief, but my friend Matrix sorted them out, and we got a couple of corpses in the back there, but they can deal with that when we're through. Now it's the connection train to Michigan. Only 3 hours of breeze after 48 hours. Come out.
Oh, it was pretty interesting, you know. A little bit enduring, but you know, we got through the stretch, you know. All in a day's work, right? So yeah, now we're coming from California. We just got into Chicago. Now we're on our way to Detroit, Michigan to do some location scouting. And if you know Detroit, there's a lot of spots in Detroit where a lot of, you know, character moments, so to speak. So this should be pretty interesting.
It's gonna be one piece. We're in the Chicago Union Station waiting for the train, so I thought we'd just take this opportunity to recap on our feature film, and that is that this is really just a recce on what, you know, to prepare the package for an investor. But through all of this, I managed to stumble across this fine gentleman here, who is actually from the area we're going to. So he's going to tell us a bit about himself and why he feels he wanted to join us on the journey.
I'm originally from Detroit, Michigan. Ran into this good buddy of mine, Ryan, actually in LA at a hostel. And we got to talking about film and, you know, myself having a big passion for film and coming off some significant film projects recently. We just hit it off. And, you know, I kind of asked him if I could tag along.
We're in for a surprise, right? You say it's kind of the gangsters in the hood.
Well, you know, like any other state, if you go on that side of town, yeah, you're gonna run into some significant,
unforeseen circumstances.
Right. So you gotta be quick with your wits, so to speak. So.
So we're in for quite a journey. It's 2 weeks in Michigan to find locations and do everything that's needed to be done, and then pretty much gonna put the whole package together.
Cool.
That's it. Arrived in Ann Harbor after 48 hours plus 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours at the airport plus 6 hours on the train. So all together it's about, I don't know, 58 hours. And
okay, you crazy.
Here's our good friend.
Welcome to Michigan. Woo, you
so
crazy.
Much.
Hello.
Hey,
how are you?
This is our friend Jody White. She's going
nice
to be helping
you,
us
Jody.
On
nice
to meet you. This is crazy.
She's going to be helping us on production, and here's all our kit.
Well, I see the train pulling away, like, okay, where are they?
Yeah, right, it didn't wait for us. He was like, we gotta go, man. So we just like throwing stuff down.
I will grab this stuff for you.
So production officially, or at least pre-production officially begins tomorrow morning for the Parricidal Effect. Cool.
So we've arrived in Ann Arbor. In fact, it's a little ways out of Ann Arbor. Forget the name of the place. But Jody's parents have made the house available to us. They've cleaned up a room. We're complete strangers to them, but they've just been so wonderful and accommodating already. Everybody's excited. Everybody's sort of, Jody's got everybody so enthusiastic and so passionate about this project that I think if we were given the go ahead, you know, for the budget, we'd start shooting tomorrow. Okay, now I'm gonna show you where we are allowed to be tonight. Mother has written a lovely little note here which says, please make yourself at home, clean towels, please don't shut off lights, health reasons, we need them on, thanks. Complete strangers, these people are just the salt of the earth. Cool, that's it. Nice, brilliant.